Dane Allen here with another video, and in this one I'm going to show you the technical preview of Veeam One V13. This is the next iteration of the product. It includes new in-house reporting engine, new agent-based data collection that's going to work with the Linux console, a new and fresh UI, new views, and much, much more. So let's get into it. Okay, we're going to be logging into the web console, the web UI. That's what all we're going to show in this demo here. A lot of great changes there. You're going to be excited to see what Veeam has brought to this web UI and how easy it's going to make it to have visibility into your virtual environments, into your backup environment. In this example, we'll just show, you know, the VMware backup environment, but it includes all of the pieces that Veeam One does today and more. So I'm logging in here with the admin credentials that, because I joined it to my domain, but you can also log in as the current user if you're on a machine. Get a little welcome screen there on your first time. Go ahead and skip it. But at login, you're met with the Veeam Threat Center, right? So this is going to be, you know, what's a high risk? What RPO anomalies you have? You know, all those pieces. Configuration is up on the top right, where you can see the data collectors, those agents that will go out to your Veeam backup replication pieces. And then here's the database. You'll notice that username says Postgres. So really keeping in the theme that Veeam is driving here in the products. Let's take a look at the report catalog, and you'll see these new, like, look like tiles. They're calling them thumbnails, where you can easily spread across and find reports that you might want to run across your environment. You can easily click into them, customize those to point at certain repositories, for instance, in this report, protected workloads, make those customizations, schedule those to run, right? Where these are sent to some group or somebody by email or saved into a folder. But it's all right there at your fingertips, right from these thumbnails. You can make those changes and set those. Right here at the top, you have this nice filtering by platform. So depending on what platform you have connected, you can click the icon that corresponds and get right to the reports that are in that group. So it makes it really easy to find, you know, the grouping that you're trying to, you know, to have a look into. Tags as well. So again, just making it really easy to organize and even have the big old list if you don't want to look at it by the thumbnails or by those filters that we just showed. Those settings, you can even kind of click here on the three-dot menu that's on the side of the thumbnail tile and, again, make those custom changes so that report reports the data that you're looking for. Save reports go there. Anything that you customize and you save, you'll have a list there as well. And you can even see here in the bottom right of each thumbnail, they have that icon, just like those filters at the top, so you know what that report corresponds to, right? That's a VBR icon. You got the VMware icon, right? Again, just making it really visually easy to find those reports that you're trying to use for whatever environment you're trying to manage or have visibility into. I go in here to the edit, kind of one of these reports. You can see the piece that would be exported if it were a CSV. And you can see you can easily, very snappy response, move those columns around. I can even dig into these and edit parameters like, or I should say filtering, so I can look at those views however I need it. So in this case, I grouped it by proxy, I grouped it by backup server, right? Whatever setting I need for that report. And then true to form, different than the old Veeam one, what I see here is what I get on the download from the CSV and no other pieces to get in the way, right? So I can customize that report on the fly in the web interface and download it and, you know, share it as needed, right? Again, make it really easy to get that visibility. Really nice reporting, really snappy interface. I like this change a lot. I used Veeam One a lot in my environments, and this would have made it even easier for my teams and me to use. Of course, we've got this alarms overview, so you can easily go see errors and warnings in your environment. You can assign components in your VBR environment, as you know, by location. And here's a nice little platform health anomalies. I can see it again by location. I can drill it down to what those objects are so that I can, again, get quick, easy visibility into my backup environment and drill down as needed. Get all the errors here with the alarm name. If I click into the alarm, it's going to give me that detail, that resolution, that summary, that cause, right from this console. And if I click into that, it's going to take me to the report catalog directly to that report that runs that, and I can set those parameters and, again, drill down in that information as needed. Of course, you got that nice alarm status overview chart there, so you can see warnings resolved. I can do total issues by day, right? It's nice and color-coded. And then I can even filter this further to maybe shrink or grow that time period so I can, again, get that visibility I need and, you know, get to results quicker, right? Get to resolving that issue quicker through this console. And again, you can change that on the fly. Again, really snappy response is what I'm really noticing. And, you know, it's not waiting a long time to query that data and move around. It's really snappy and really responsive. I like this job calendar. You can kind of go in here and drill down by a day, or we can spread this out to a week, right? And we can see the jobs that have run, when they run, when I have a restore point. I can look at them, again, by month, so I can schedule out, oh, what's the schedule look like? What has run across the month? I can drill down into those jobs if I don't want to see everything. I just want to see specific jobs, right? These are all jobs in my environment, my lab environment. I could look at them by job status. So, hey, what's passed? What hasn't passed? Right? Where are my errors for the last month, for the last week, et cetera? And I can even drill it down by backup server if I'm managing more than one. So, again, just another step to go, hey, I need visibility into my environment, and I want to see what jobs have ran by week, by month. This little deployment projects, it's kind of nice, right? I did a test one here. Here I can model a little right from this web interface changes into my virtual environment, for instance. So I set this up kind of minimal and it was passed. I'm going to change that one of those parameters, recalculate that. We'll see that it's not passed. I can drill into the report. So this is a little different. It's going to take me out of the report here. This is something you wouldn't do often, but you might want to model, right? If I add a certain workload to this environment, if I have picked a certain workload for this environment, right? What's that change going to look like across my clusters, my hosts, etc., right? And I can kind of make decisions or look at growth or additional resources I may need for my environment. So just nice little feature built in. So dashboard scheduling, and we're going to go up to dashboard catalog. So outside of reports, we have dashboards. And again, this is going to be high level dashboards that, you know, out of the box, you can go look at it by feedback of replication, your vSphere environment, heat maps. We look at vSphere trends here, but just really high level information about how usage by memory, CPU, VMware growth. I can easily, again, that snappy interface, move things around to customize that dashboard to fit my needs or the needs of maybe my management or somebody else, another team. I can add widgets so I can customize these dashboards. Again, all through from this web interface. It's very responsive. Go ahead and put last month there. And if I, for some reason, wanted to mix proxy usage with my, you know, my vSphere usage, I could go ahead and do that, make my own custom dashboards based on these out-of-the-box tiles. So really nice, really easy to work with. Let me look at the Veeam backup and replication one. Again, really nice out-of-the-box. It's got the things you'll want to see, but you can go and customize that and add new widgets as needed. So really, all in all, a really great interface. I showed you all these tabs, but what's really nice here at the top is I can go directly to what I need from the main login. So I can log in, I see Threat Center, I can go search across that by name. I did protected VMs. I see all the choices I get. I can get right to that report, make the changes I need, or just do the preview and get right to managing or seeing what that environment or that piece of the environment or the environment by that perspective looks like, right? I don't even have to go down and search through the catalog. I can scroll through the report data. Again, I can edit those parameters and customize that. I can download it as we've shown before. But anyway, just getting you even quicker to what you're looking for, right? By just starting a keyword search from the front login, right? The first page you log in, or really any page that you are in the web interface. And this is, as it says at the top, not just reports, but dashboards, alarms, more, right? You just kind of hit those keywords and maybe what you're looking to manage or take a look at. So just backup in general, and you can choose across those catalog or those choices, reports, again, dashboards, whatever it is. And again, just get directly to that resource very easily from the web console at first login. So all in all, I think it's a really easy interface to do. Very powerful tool. Veeam One always has been, right? Getting you to that data, giving you the action, that data, being able to take a look and help you make decisions, right? Take information to management to look at new resources, right? Or make different changes in your environment. And this upgrade really just makes it a lot easier to use that tool directly from the web interface without even having to install a client on your desktop. And again, get to resolution quicker. So with that, I hope you enjoyed this video. I'd be curious in some of your feedback and other things you want to see. But this has been Veeam One. It's going to connect to Veeam Backup and Replication version 13. So until next time, it's been Zane Allen, and I appreciate you watching.